Last year, just after Theresa May became Prime Minister, you might remember this, she came up, I think 2 days after she became Prime Minister, she came up to meet with me in Bute House in Edinburgh. And I remember thinking that day that regardless of political differences, regardless of politics, the image of a female First Minister of Scotland meeting with a female Prime Minister of the UK was quite a powerful one for other women and possibly especially for young girls. It sent a message, I guess, that anything's possible. There are no areas that any longer should be seen as being off limits for women. And I was thinking this in that meeting, and I remember vividly coming out of that meeting and looking at what was happening on social media, and the first image of Theresa May and I meeting on the steps of Bute House that I saw when I went onto social media had cut both of us off at the knees, because it was an image illustrating a story about what shoes we'd both been wearing. So here you had two female leaders discussing fairly important things, fairly important things like Brexit and the future of the country. But some journalist somewhere had decided that the most important thing about that meeting was to compare the shoes that we were wearing. And the same actually happened a few months later when I went to visit Theresa May in Downing Street. And one newspaper, which shall remain nameless, but a tabloid red top newspaper, after that meeting, illustrated with a photograph of me walking down Downing Street, had the headline, First Minister tries to outdo the Prime Minister on the shoe front. And again, there was a picture of me from the knees down. Now, don't get me wrong, I like shoes. I actually really like shoes. They're one of my biggest weaknesses. But I think there's more to women politicians than the shoes they wear. And I can't imagine, and I know it never ever happened, and I can't imagine it ever happening in the future, when Alex Salmond went to meet David Cameron in Downing Street, would have been interested in their shoes. I have to say, having seen Alex Salmond's shoes close up, that's probably quite a good thing. But the fact is, and this is a serious point, it is, of course, I laugh at it often, but it's a serious point. Women are judged differently, and the criteria that you're judged by are very, very different. Now, that focus on how we look and what we wear is something that after more than 20 years in politics, I've become personally quite inured to. I don't really, apart from these kind of particularly humorous examples that I'm talking about, it's not something that I pay too much attention to. But I do know from discussions with younger women that it is still something that is potentially off-putting to a younger woman considering a career in politics or public life.